The mercy that has brought us this far. And I pray you have your way with my tongue, with my mouth, with my mind. That I do all that you require me to do with this message. Pray that it be written in indelible ink on the hearts of the people. That they can refer to it day after day. And cry out to you, Father. Your help for their soul. In your Jesus' name we pray. In your great name we sing. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let's y'all hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yes, he is.
Now we give him true praise.
Yes. Right.
If you will, turn me to the book of Isaiah chapter 58. Isaiah 58. Speak to me. Don't let this message be for somebody else. Somebody else. Somebody else. Say, Father, speak to me. In the book of Isaiah chapter 58, we're going to look at one verse and we're going to move on from there. And that one verse says, cry aloud. Do not spare. Lift up your voice like the shofar. Declare to my people their transgression and the house of Israel, or Yaakov, their sins. You may be seated. Brothers and sisters, what we are talking about today is crying out aloud. Crying out aloud from within. Until your soul gets stirred up within, you cannot cry out aloud from within. We have to be stirred up on the inside. And sometimes I wonder, by looking at this world, being that I'm in the world, but not of the world, but I'm looking at it and I'm saying, what is it going to take to stir up the people enough that they cry out? What is it going to take? Have we not seen enough degradation? Have we not felt enough pain? Have we not heard enough lies? Have we not seen enough hurt and suffering in the world that we have not learned to cry out? Why do we sit down so nonchalantly and not give the Father his due praise?
Help us, y'all.
What do we think is going through the mind of Yahweh? We sit quietly by and watch 5,000 babies be slain every month. What do we think that the Father gave us his children to rear in his nurture, in his admonition, and we teach them everything but the right thing? It's time for us to cry out from down in our souls, or maybe we're not disturbed enough. I'm going to tell you like I feel it. I think we need to cry out now. I think he has shown us enough to stir us up on the inside. Get some of that righteous indignation stirred up. Then begin to cry out to him, because we want, we got to have something from heaven to solve the problems on earth.
Hallelujah.
We look at the problematic situations on earth, and you know what? Sometimes I think we don't feel like we're a part of the problem. Well, if you're not a part of the solution, you are indeed a part of the problem.
Yeah.
If you don't feel like shouting, that's all right.
Yeah,
I'm going to keep preaching this message, because it's a message that's intended for us.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I brought this message to the assembly, but I wasn't sure until this morning in our discussion time that the Father pointed out to me we need to know about crying out.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We want things from the Father, but it's like we're trying to whisper. And so many people have told me, well, he hears a whisper. I'm sure he does. I'm sure he does. But if the people of Diana can cry out for hours,
that's right.
Yes.
It seems as though to me we ought to be able to cry out to our Father.
Oh,
hallelujah.
Yeah.
Diana can't talk, can't walk, can't see, can't hear. Can't do anything. But our Father hears our humble cry.
Thank you.
I just said. Now he hears our humble cries.
Yes.
When the word cry is used in the scriptures, it's used for shouting. It means to speak out aloud, and speak out with intensity, speak out with great feeling. But brothers and sisters, when we cry to the Father, it's like a whisper, like a little whisper that we're afraid to say something with any type of volume to it. But now when we get home, we see a lot of stuff loud.
Yeah.
Isn't that right? Sometimes it ain't even like stuff. But we get loud at home. But get quiet in time to praise and worship. Brothers and sisters, it's time to change our format of usage of words and begin to give the Father the power of the thrust of your crying out to Him. I don't know about y'all, but I made my mind up before this morning, but it intensified this morning. But I'm going to cry out to the Father more now.
Hallelujah.
Because what I see going on in this world, we need to cry out.
Yes, indeed.
Luke chapter 18, if you care to follow with me, I'm not going to slow down. Because nighttime comes quick these days, and I want to get as much of this in as I can. Luke 18, verse number 7 says, shall Elohim not do right by all means to his own chosen ones? Who will cry out day and night to him? And being patient over them? Let me tell y'all something. He said, because y'all might have missed it, let me say it again. Shall not the Almighty do right by his saints that cry out to him day and night? See, we don't wait till we get to prayer meeting and cry out. We don't wait until we get to services like this to cry out. We're supposed to cry out day and night. That's at home, that's here, that's in your car, that's in the shopping center, that's wherever you go. You ought to be crying out so much that when you're walking through Walmart and you holler out, oh, bless your name. Somebody say, see, we should not have a certain place where we can cry out. We should be able to cry out anywhere in heaven. We need him at home. We need him here. We need him when we're driving, for sure. We need him in the store. We need him everywhere. So why don't we cry out from sincere hearts?
Thank you, God. Thank you.
Cry out like you really need him.
Yes, indeed.
You know, if you were drowning and you were over there saying, I'll keep on fishing.
Yeah, that's true.
Because I would think you know me, and you ain't nothing on me. You trying to fool me. See, if you scream out, help!
Yeah,
I'm going to leave. You're going to get my attention.
Right.
Hallelujah. See, the Father is waiting for his children to show intensity in what they really want.
Yeah.
See, you really wanted that car, so you really wanted that wife, and you really wanted that husband, and you really wanted that baby, and you really wanted these things, but you cried out then.
Yeah, that's true.
But after you got it, you got quiet again.
Yes.
The Father said, okay, I'm going to ask, I got to wait another 5 years to see what else was. But see, it's time for us to cry out. Somebody say right now.
Right now.
He came back in Luke 18. He said, I said to you that he will do right to them speedily. Yeah. But when the Son of Adam come, when the Son of Man come, will he find faith on the earth?
Yeah.
See, when we cry out, we need to cry out with faith. Yeah. Believing.
Yeah.
That's what the devil told us, right?
Yeah.
He said, if anything you ask, believe. And not doubt what you ask for. That's why y'all see me speaking words and I'm not afraid to speak them. Y'all see me doing things and I'm not afraid to do them because by faith.
Hallelujah.
He promised that he would never leave me nor forsake me. When my trouble comes, he said, I'm a very present help in the time of trouble.
Yes.
No fear.
Yep.
Because whatever he does is well done.
Hallelujah.
We have to accept some things we don't want to accept because it's not going according to our way.
Yep.
I want you to know the Father got his own program.
Yes.
And we got to fit into his program.
Yes.
He knows what's best.
Yep.
They made a show about him a long time ago called Father Knows Best.
Yes.
Yes, indeed.
They didn't know they were making it for us, but we understand now they were making it for us.
Yeah.
Our Father knows what's best for us.
Yes.
Yep.
Everything we want is not what we need.
Yes,
isn't that right?
That's right.
That's right.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Psalm 88, verse number 1 says, O Yah, Elohim of my salvation, I cry to you day and night. Now there's David the king. And David said he cried before him day and night.
Yes.
Brothers and sisters, I want y'all to know that when David cried out, David was heard in heaven.
Yes.
Because he wasn't ashamed even though he was a king. He cried out. He wasn't ashamed even though he wasn't a king to dance before him. Dance out of his clothes. What worried about what people think about him.
Right.
We sit right here, and we don't cry out because we're ashamed to cry out.
Help us, yeah.
How somebody looking at you, what they're going to think about you, what they're going to say about you. I'm going to tell you what I feel about that. I don't care. I know I need something from the Father, so you can talk about me as much as you please.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to cry out anyway.
Hallelujah.
Because I know I need it.
Hallelujah.
And I know what I want from him.
Yeah.
So I cry out to him sometimes day and night. While I'm driving in my truck and somebody looked at me and said, that man is gone crazy in that truck.
Right.
Who is he talking to like that? My hand be flying sometimes all out the window. I don't care. You know, and people be looking at me, what you looking at? You can come to my post on the road, we'll pray together.
Hallelujah.
Because I need some help.
Help. Hallelujah.
Praise him.
Hallelujah.
To do what I got to do. But I, unto you, I have cried, O Yah, and in the morning my prayer come before you.
Yes.
Yah, why are you rejecting me? Why do you hide your face from me? Don't you feel like that sometimes?
Yes.
Even though you get kind of loud and cry out to the Father, it's even though you back up a little bit.
Yeah.
And you're wondering, what's wrong? What he's saying is, you're not ready for the answer you're asking for. You're not ready. See, sometimes we think we're ready for something, and the Father says, you're never ready. But you keep crying out to him, and ultimately he'll give it to you, and then you'll find out while that sermon came out, you got what you wanted, but do you want?
What you got.
Hallelujah. Take your time, congregation of Yahweh. Take your time, people who are listening by television and radio. Take your time. Stop being in a hurry. Time is coming to an end swifter than you think.
That's right.
And the most important thing that you need to do is get yourself right with the Father. Stop worrying about a husband and wife and clothes and cars and money and all that. Get your life right with the Father.
Yes.
That's the main thing we need to get to. Am I right about it?
Yes, sir.
So he's not rejecting you. He promised that he would never leave you. He would never forsake you. That means he's there all the time.
Hallelujah.
But even though you don't feel like you feel him, don't worry about it. He ain't going nowhere. He's just not there the way you want him to be there. See, we got to get ourselves off the throne and let him get on the throne.
Yes.
He don't have to answer to you the way you want it. You want him to answer to you. He is the king.
Yes.
He is the one in charge.
Yeah.
He is the one on the throne in your heart.
Yeah.
If he's not, you still there.
Yeah. Yeah.
And if you still on your throne, there ain't no room for him.
Mm-hmm.
Are y'all hearing me today?
Yes.
Luke chapter 2, verse number 36 says, and there was Hannah. That's Luke 2. Verse 36, there was Hannah, a prophetess, a daughter of Penuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years. She was an old lady and had lived with her husband 7 years from her maidenhood. And she was a widow about 84 years. Who did not leave the set apart place, but she served Almighty Yahweh fasting and praying night. See, we don't take time out like that. We got too much going on in our life. Matter of fact, we tell Almighty Yahweh, you stand over here for a minute. I got to do this right now. I got to make some money right now. I got to buy some cars. I got to buy clothes. I got to go and put in my bid for a house because I want a house. And I'll get to you later, Father. And we get so busy on our job. And we get so busy with our children and our stuff. And we got to take our them. And then every now and then, maybe about an hour on the Sabbath, we pull them into our lives. And after an hour, I gotta get back to doing what I was doing. And I'll get back to you next week. Now, you be calm over there. I'll call you when I need you. Father, help us today.
Help us. Help us.
He should be the most prominent thing in our lives.
Right.
He should be our focal point every day. But we wake up with so many other things on our heart, we don't have time for him.
Hallelujah.
Until we feel like we need him. And then we call him back. We got to change around the negative comment. But until I pull that chain, you stay right there. Don't get my business. Y'all know what I'm talking about, don't you? Because you want to do it the way you want to do it, when you want to do it, how you want to do it. And then when the way you want to do it don't work, you pull this chain. Now you want him to come in and fix what you messed up.
Yeah. That's what we do. That's how we do it.
But we should have been crying out to him from the very beginning. From the inception of our problematic situation, we should be calling on him.
Yes.
Putting him first. Why? Because he should be first in your life.
Yes.
But you, and only you, can tell where he is in your life. You know if he is first or last. It's wherever you put him. Hallelujah. Help us a bit, Father. 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 9. Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 9. For what things are we able to return to Almighty Yah for you? All the joy with which we rejoice for your sake in the presence of our Lord here. This is what we're going to do. Since you've been so good to us, this is what we're going to do. In 1 Thessalonians 3:10, he said, night and day. Y'all see that?
Yeah.
Praying how?
Exceedingly.
Praying how?
Exceedingly.
That's not little weak prayers. You know, the little weak prayers we pray, don't even get into them no more. Just get out and say, throw down here, get up.
Yeah.
You ain't got time for that. You know, your movie coming out.
Wow.
And you can watch a movie for 2 hours.
2 hours.
Ooh.
Yeah. Ouch.
But you give the Father 2 minutes in your time. I watch people, you know, praise time, oh, we can pray as long as Anderson and Flynn is on the instrument and this and that, but soon as the music stops,
that's it.
You ain't got nothing else to say. Soon as the hand clapping stops, you ain't clapping your hand. See, but somebody here gonna get bold enough that you gonna clap if nobody else don't clap.
Hallelujah.
You gonna clap when they at least expect you to clap.
Yes,
you gonna shout hallelujah when everybody else quiet. Because whenever the Father starts affecting you and stirring you up on the inside, you ought to be the one to get shouting and hollering out.
Yeah.
Because you know that word is just for you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You know that the Father is pulling and tugging at your heart. And you ought to be the one to cry out to him. He's the one that answers your prayer. He's the one to cut your heart. He's the one. Snow falling everywhere. Trees falling. Didn't even fall on your house.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Peter, So you might not see me what I'm doing, but I cry out, running home safe.
Hallelujah.
Soon a little trouble come, we run.
Hallelujah.
We run to the establishment. Help!
Yes, indeed.
We give them money to help us. Pay people to help us.
Hallelujah.
And we got somebody sitting on this throne who is willing to help you for free.
For free.
Hallelujah. Yeah. He said, if you call on me, if you cry out to me, I will answer.
I will answer.
Yes,
indeed.
Y'all don't believe that promise?
Yes.
That's a promise.
Yeah.
If you cry out to me, I will.
Hallelujah.
Haven't you seen him answer you before?
Yeah.
Okay. He's shown you. He got a track record
of
answering prayer.
Hallelujah.
Well, I'm looking at some of y'all in here. Everybody in here is an answered prayer.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I look at that baby right there. That baby right there is an answer. Slave, and you know. somebody?
Hallelujah.
Yeah, we got kind of quiet now. That's all right.
Hallelujah.
The Father talking to
yes,
us.
Yes, yes, indeed.
We are in bondage to something
talk
or another. And whatever it is, you are the one that should be crying out from within.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Is that bothering you?
Yeah.
See, when something really bothers you, you will cry out.
Yes.
Yep, that's true.
Isn't that right?
Yes, that's right.
If there's something you really, 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 really want,
yeah,
you'll cry out.
Yes.
So that's telling me that the thing that you are bound to, you're not ready to get rid of it yet. That's why you're not crying out. You ain't ready to get rid of it. You playing with it. You still love it, pretending that you don't. That's why I preached a message one time before called the Great Pretenders.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. See, we are great pretenders. How many of y'all know it's time for pretensions to end?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's start being real.
Yeah.
With
yeah.
Father, yeah. Father, I've been saying I don't like this man, but I do. And I'm asking you, I'm crying out to you to give me the strength to turn away from it.
Yes.
Because I've been playing like I want to give it up.
Yeah.
But I keep going back to it. See, whatever you want to give up, you're not going to keep going back to it.
That's right.
If you really want to give it up.
That's the truth.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
So if you're still going back to it, you want to do it.
Yeah.
Right. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Somebody hallelujah.
Yep. Hallelujah.
Thank you. We got to admit. 1 John chapter 1, verse number 9. You don't have to go there. I'm just quoting the scripture to you. 1 John chapter 1, verse number 9 says, if we confess our sins. See, the reason why we don't confess, because we want to stay in our mess. Because if you confess it, he is just and righteous to cleanse you from it.
Yep.
And forgive you for it.
Yes,
indeed.
If you just confess it. But the problem is, we don't want to confess it. Because we ain't through messing with it yet. We ain't not tired of it yet. We still want to play. You know, I'm going to quit smoking next week, next month, next year. Every time I look around, you're sticking a cigarette in your mouth. I ain't going to gamble no more. But every time I look around, you're pulling on that one-handed arm. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna cuss no more, but every time somebody get you a little bit upset, the bad words fly out your mouth.
Yes,
I'm talking to somebody.
Yes.
You see, when you cry out to the Father, I'm tired of living like this.
Hallelujah.
I don't want to do that no more.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
I'm here to tell you what I know for myself. He will answer your prayer.
Yes, he will.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise him.
Hallelujah.
If Brother BJ was here, he'd tell you I was the greatest argumentative person you could ever meet in your life. I'll argue with you from the day in the morning till the next day. I don't do that no more.
Hallelujah.
You know why? I got tired.
Praise
I got tired of arguing with people. You know, you argue with somebody about what they want to do. That ain't your business.
Yeah.
That's their business. If they want to do that, let them do it.
Yeah.
All my job is to tell you the truth. Not arguing with you about it. You either receive it or reject it. That's your prerogative.
Yeah, hallelujah.
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 I had to learn that. And once I learned that, I went before him and I cried out, Father, come on now. Because every time I get upset, I'm going to argue again. I don't argue with people. I don't want to argue with Sister Lee.
Hallelujah.
And she'll tell you, I don't argue with her no more.
That's
a blessing. I state my case and leave it alone.
Yes, indeed.
You can do it or you don't.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. You'd be surprised at how much peace stays in your heart.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, that's true.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise you, Father.
See, we got to get to that point, but if we don't cry out for that, you're going to keep on being that negative person. You're going to keep on being that argumentative person. You're going to keep on being disturbed in your spirit, and you're going to be no good to nobody else and you to yourself.
Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But until you feel it down on the inside, you're not going to cry out for that change to take place in
your
life. Hallelujah. Some of y'all still bind service to your past.
Yeah.
Haven't cut it loose yet. turn it off.
Yeah.
If you can just trust him for a little while.
Yes, indeed.
Look at chapter 3 in the same book of Exodus. Chapter 3, verse number 7. And Almighty Yah said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people.
Yes,
you think he don't see what you're going through?
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does.
Which are in Mithraim. And I have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters.
Yes, indeed.
For I know their sorrow.
Know our sorrow.
He knows your sorrow. He knows that in your heart you want to serve him day and night because you got to work for that man who don't give a hoot about you.
Right.
All he cares about is how much money you can make for him.
That's right.
Yeah. Hallelujah. He don't care about, well, I want to keep the Sabbath. I'm going to get another job. I want somebody to work for me 7 days a week.
Yes.
You see how much he loves you. He don't love you.
Yep.
He don't even love himself.
Yep.
If he loved himself, he wouldn't be working on the Sabbath.
Yes, indeed.
Am I making sense to y'all?
Yes.
Why would we desecrate something that's kodesh? Yes. Something that's set apart for the master? Yes. Why would we profane the Sabbath if we say we love him?
Right.
Come on, talk to me now. See, why would we do that? Why would we deliberately go against him to do what we want to do? That's the same thing with lying, the dog, and stealing, and killing, and everything else. Why? We got to choose not to. If we love him. Why would you want to hurt the one you love? What are you quiet in? Why am I preaching today? But we got the propensity to hurt people that we love. No, let me change that. Thank you, Father. We got the propensity to hurt people that we say we love.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. We can say it all we want, but your lifestyle tells the story.
Right.
You know that right?
Yes.
He said, I've seen your affliction. I see what you're going through. We go through life sometimes. We think the Father don't see all the pain we got in our heart and our mind. We act like the Father don't see our pain from how people treat us and the pain from how we don't have this and how we don't have that. The Father sees all of that.
Yes,
he sees all of your affliction.
Yes, he does.
Yep.
He see all of your sorrows.
Yes,
matter of fact, not only does he see them, he feels.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Ooh,
yes,
indeed. See, but see, we don't understand that love that he has for us, that he can feel your pain.
Yes, indeed.
And that's the kind of love he wants us to have for one another.
Yeah.
You understand? But are we establishing that kind of love?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
That we can feel each other's pain. Can we even see each other's afflictions? Are we even concerned about what our brothers and our sisters are going through? Are we even concerned? You know, we heard Sister Beth cry out for her son this morning. How many of us felt her pain?
Hallelujah.
Feeling it. See, we gotta feel something. That means your heart gotta be circumcised.
Yeah.
People going out here worrying about circumcision of the flesh. You can be circumcised in your heart. So you can begin to feel the Father's moving in your life.
Yeah.
When he speaks to you, you ought to feel something. There shouldn't be a conversation going on in the middle of the sermon. There shouldn't be texting on a telephone in the middle of a sermon. Unless you're putting on the ministry live. You got the aptitude to do that, you ought to do that. But don't sit up and just play games.
Hallelujah.
In the Father's house while he's speaking to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We need to respect him more than that.
Yeah.
So he says, since I know I've seen your affliction and since I've heard your cry, and since I know your sorrows, I'm coming down to deliver you out of the hands of those who have you in mind. And bring them up out of that land unto a good land and a large land, a land flowing with milk and honey, unto the place of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Amorites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites. I'm going to come and get you.
Hallelujah.
You know why he haven't come down us yet? We don't show him that we ready to make no kind of move. We have become very complacent right where we are. We're satisfied right where we are. And the Father constantly showing us stuff. He said, now, what if the snow comes and you depended on these folks for your lights, what you gonna do? What if you go to the gas station, and because of the snow and the power outages, you can't even get fuel? What you gonna do? Who are you gonna depend on then? You can't go to Walmart because everybody done had that thought, went to Walmart, bought all the food they got in there. Didn't we see that? We saw that during the storm. We walked in the store, they had nothing on the shelf. We went to gas station after gas station and couldn't find gas. We went looking for ice and couldn't find no ice. What you gonna do then? Who you gonna depend on then? When my children came out of Mithraim, I gave them bread from heaven. Yes. And I know y'all have heard people say, bread from heaven, bread from heaven. Feed me till I'm hungry. And he's giving bread out in this congregation abundantly.
Thank you, Father.
But just like the people of Yah wasn't satisfied with their bread, we are not satisfied with the word that comes from heaven. So he said, oh, you want flesh. So he sent quails to them. They still complain. Now we want some water. You get water out of a rock. And they still complain. They went to Myra and got water that was bitter. He showed them how to make it sweet and they still complain. Until they made gods and said, these be your gods that brought you out. See, we worshiping all these false deities and we supposed to be worshiping him. But you need to read the scripture that says they feared Yahweh and they kept doing what they were doing.
Yes, indeed.
Wow. That's oxymoronic. Yeah.
Right, for sure.
That's people who are disturbed. How you going to serve Yahweh and keep on serving paganism?
Right.
Well, that's what you're talking about. Let me make it a little bit plainer for you since we're in the season. Mm-hmm. How you going to serve Yahweh and keep Christmas?
Right.
Yeah.
That's Nimrod's birthday.
Yep.
How you going to do that? How you gonna serve Easter and call that Yahweh resurrection when Easter is a celebration of that starting? How you gonna do that? How you gonna be serving Yahweh and serving Enoch? That's Valentine's Day. How you gonna do that? And he gave you feast days to celebrate your one day.
Right, yeah.
Now you come up with replacement theology. And here's the Sabbath on the seventh day, and you want to do it on the first day. Right. Does everybody else do it? Okay, follow everybody else. The wide road leads to one place.
Mm-hmm.
And that straight and narrow road that be few in it, that leads to one place.
Yeah.
That's the way I want to go. Where the few is. Have we all noticed that the Father deals with the few more than he deals with the many?
Oh, yeah. Right.
You ever noticed that yet? You know, he told Israel, I chose you because you're the smallest among the nation. When he sent the disciples, I sent them two by two. When he started his assembly, he only had 12 men. Then he told us where two or three are gathered in my name.
Right.
That's where I'm going to be.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah, I'm here today. He's here today. You don't call on Yah. You call on Dr. Tishner, Kings and Pete. Yeah. With a little song of praise. Y'all never heard that, huh? It's Dr. Tishner, Kings and Pete, with a little song of praise. See, that's the one that was for antiseptic. Dr. Tishner's antiseptic. That's an old commercial. But they sing a little song of praise for Dr. Tishner. And we give praises to all these doctors and because we run to him before we run to Yah. How many of y'all know that Yah can heal you?
Hallelujah!
Don't be scared of that, baby. I ran to him before.
Hallelujah.
But when I went to him, it was after I went through stuff.
Yes, indeed.
And then the Father said, now do this, now do that. But he let me go through something so I can have a testimony.
Hallelujah.
Of my enduring power, where I was able to endure.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Never once did I use my mouth to go against it.
Hallelujah.
No matter what I've gone through.
Thank you, Father.
And no matter what I've got to go through, I've got to go through something more.
Yes.
Yeah. If it's His will, get ready for it.
Hallelujah.
Whatever it is.
Thank you, Father.
Can I get a witness in
here?
Judges chapter 10, verse 11 says these words. That's Judges 10. Chapter 10, that's Shofatim. Judges chapter 10, verse 11. And the Almighty said unto the children of Israel, didn't I deliver you from the Egyptians?
Mm-hmm.
Didn't I deliver you from the Amorites?
Yes.
From Ammon?
Yes.
Didn't I deliver you from the Philistines?
Yes, he did.
The Zidonians also?
He will do it again.
And I delivered you from the Amalekites and the Midianites?
Yeah.
All of them that oppressed you?
Mm-hmm.
You? And you cried to me, and I delivered you out of their hands. How many of us need deliverance now? Anybody need to be delivered from alcoholism? Anybody need to be delivered from nicotine? Anybody need to be delivered from the bad things going through your mind?
Hallelujah.
Anybody need deliverance? Anybody need deliverance from cussing?
Yes.
See? How long am I evil thinking? See, do you need deliverance in the
end?
If you need deliverance, really want deliverance, what should you do? Should be some crying out going on in here. If you really want to be delivered. But if you don't really want to be delivered, then stop going around talking about what you're trying to stop doing. Because you ain't trying to stop.
Hallelujah.
When you really want to stop, you're going to cry out to Him and watch and see if He don't stop.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
I used to smoke.
Yeah, me too.
I don't smoke no more.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
I used to be a drunk. I don't get drunk no more. And if you ever wanted to see a sailor cuss, I was a sailor that did some cussing. Matter of fact, some of y'all probably using the words I made up. That's how good I was. But the Father took cussing clean out of my mouth.
Hallelujah.
That don't mean I don't still have some things to contend with. Hallelujah. We discussed that in Sabbath class this morning. All of us got something we got to fight. Is that right?
Yes.
I mean, I know we got some perfect ones in here who got in that better fight. Look, I'll bow to you. Pray for me.
Yes.
I mean, my trunk, when he finally got to me, or when I finally got to him, my trunk was full. Couldn't close that book. But now you can close it.
Hallelujah.
That's progress.
Yes,
he said, look what he said again. In Judges 10, the latter portion of verse number 12, we're going to go to the B portion. You know, that's how they teach you. And I delivered you out of their hand. Y'all see that?
Yes.
Then he said, but yet you have forsaken me and served other gods. Wherefore I will deliver you no more. See, people think that they can just keep pushing the fire. But it'll get to a certain point yeah, he's going to get bricks on you. He's going to say, okay, you want to keep doing that? You love the bondage that you're in? Go ahead. I'm done. So look what he said. Since you want to worship these other gods, what other gods? You know, Christmas and Easter and Halloween and Mardi Gras and Valentine's Day and on and on. You want to worship all of them things? You want to worship the Sunday God? You want to worship that too? Go ahead. But look what he said right here. Look what he said. Since you want to worship them, verse number 14, go ahead and cry unto those gods. That you have chosen. No. Let them deliver you in the time of your tribulation. No. Go cry to them. No. See, people never get read this.
No.
But this is what the Father said.
Yes, indeed.
Since you don't believe in those other gods, go to them. Go ask Cupid to deliver you from sickness and disease.
Right.
Go on, go ahead. Go tell Santa Claus to save your children.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Go tell him that. Go and tell Astarte to come and fix your husband and your wife for you.
Mm-hmm.
Go pray to them. Since you want to worship them, go ahead. Don't call me.
Mm-hmm.
What are you calling me for if you don't believe in me?
That's true.
If you don't trust me to do it, what you calling on me for?
Mm-hmm.
That's a bogus telephone call. You know, like the phone calls we get at our houses. This is unavailable. This is unavailable. Who's unavailable? And they don't want you to know who it is. Because it's a business call. You know we ignore the call.
Yes.
But guess what the Father said? When I put my hand on your shoulder, and you pull away from me, he said, when you call on me in your time of calamity, I will not hear you.
Yeah.
That's the word.
I will not hear you. How many of us need him to hear us today?
Yeah.
We need him.
Hallelujah.
We need him to hear us right now. Can I say
right now?
Right now. Oh, help us, Father.
Hallelujah.
And to him in Psalm 18, verse number 6, he said, in my distress, see, then the enemy was telling us some stuff here, y'all. He said, in my distress,
yes.
I called upon Almighty Yah and cried unto the great Elohim, my Father. He heard my voice out of his temple. And my cry came before him, even into his ears.
Hallelujah.
And what happened after that, David? The earth shook and trembled. The foundations also the hills moved and were shaken because he was angry.
Yes.
See, when you call on him because people messing with you, messing up on you, hurting you, breaking your heart, destroying your vision, he gets angry with them.
Hallelujah.
That's what I tell y'all. When people go against y'all, pray for them. Because the Father puts up an arm, and just can't get off.
That's right.
Pray for them. Pray for the ones who misuse you. Pray for the ones that, but really pray for them. Pray for them with sincerity of heart.
Right.
Hallelujah.
The Father could kill them.
That's right. Yes, he will.
Yeah. I'm serious, y'all.
I didn't see it happen.
A lot of folks don't pray for the people who kicking you and knocking you down and running over you with the bus and all that kind of foolishness. They're not praying for them. But see, when you don't pray for them, you get a telephone call. Do you know so-and-so? Had a major accident.
Mm-hmm.
You know, more than so-and-so is dying. Now you want to pray for him.
Yeah.
No, you should have prayed for him when
they
did you suffer. Because
yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
The Father saw it. Y'all hear me, don't you?
Yeah.
That's why Stephen, when he was being stoned to death, he said, Father, forgive him. Because he knew when he looked up into heaven and saw the one who's supposed to be seated at the right hand of Yah, standing at the right hand of Yah, he knew that the Messiah was upset.
Yes.
You messing with my mind.
Hallelujah.
So he prayed for him right there. So here the Messiah is, he being crucified. But he looked up into heaven and he saw the Father was pretty upset with Israel. And he said, forgive them for they know not what they did. How many people have you forgiven them? Not so this in the past. Have you forgiven them for what they've done? Watch this. Have you forgiven them for what they're doing?
Yes, indeed.
Gotcha.
So you gotta forgive them.
Yeah.
Even while they're still doing it.
Yes.
The Father looked at your heart.
That's right. That is it.
Because you belong to him.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise Almighty God.
Yeah.
Drop Psalms 81. See, we still dealing with that. We eat David. Psalms 81, 6. I removed his shoulder from the burden. How many? Did the Father remove your shoulder from the burden?
Absolutely.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, Todaya.
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 I removed his shoulder from the burden, his hands were delivered from the pots. He ain't got to be cooking for nobody. You call in trouble, and I deliver. You call, I deliver.
Hallelujah.
When I hear my dump truck business down my mantra, you call, I will haul. But here the Father saying, you call, I deliver.
Yes,
hallelujah. Praise Him.
Hallelujah.
How many of y'all called on Him, He delivered from you?
Yeah.
I answered you in the secret place of thunder.
Yeah.
I proved you at the waters of Meribah. Then he said, "Say, you know what he's saying right there? Take a pause and think about it. Think about what I've delivered you from. Think about how I've saved you from. Think about how I've blessed you. Think about how I've nurtured you. Think about how I've taught you. Think about how I've done so much for you. Just think about it." And when you think about it, it should stir something up on the inside and make you cry out, "Hey! Hallelujah!"
Hallelujah.
Anybody got a shepherd shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Psalms 107, what you got more, David? Verse number 19, he said, "Then they cried unto the Almighty in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses." And you get a chance to read all of 107. Because it shows you, you got to go through something before you cry out. He sent his word. What did his word do? In verse number 20. His word healed them. Y'all see that? His word delivered them from their destruction. Why do we get so much word in this congregation? Because we need a healing. And we need deliverance. When we gave ourselves to the Father, we were all scratched up, beat up. All mean the devil had to put some whipping on us. And the Father said, "Okay, you heard my word and it came to me. Now I'm going to heal you.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to send my word to heal you." Has His word come to you yet?
Yeah.
Watch this. This is not the terminology. Have Dr. Word come to you yet?
Hallelujah.
Have Dr. Word ministered to you yet?
Hallelujah.
Yeah. See, that's what He's doing to us right now.
Yes.
Uh-huh. He is healing us from our lack of physical way of praying to Him. And our little timid way of crying out to Him. Yeah. He's trying to heal us from that.
Hallelujah.
So that we can cry out with all of our heart.
Hallelujah.
Let Him know we mean what we say.
Yes, indeed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody else said, "Heal me,
yeah." Heal me, yeah.
Then he says in verse number 21, "Oh, that men would praise the Almighty for His goodness and for His wonderful works for the children of men."
Thank you, Father.
Let me get a chance to read all of that chapter 107. I'm going to tell you, it's a blessing to read that. Because it's going to teach you, you don't have to go through all of that before you cry out to Him.
Yes, indeed.
Why wait until we went through all the suffering and pain, then cry out? Why not as soon as it start, cry out? First, it's going to be the pain you feel. Okay, Father?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes,
and cry out to Him.
Hallelujah.
The other day, I felt the pain hit me over here. And then left from here, started hitting me like it was reaching from here, hitting me in the head. And I said, "Oh, no, you don't."
Hallelujah.
I belong to Yah.
Yes.
Wherever you are, wherever you are, get away from me.
Hallelujah.
I ain't felt it no more.
Thank you.
See, we got to let the devil know. I ain't worried about you. You can't do anything to me without your
permission.
And He's done a lot. But the Father and the devil.
Praise,
hallelujah.
Praise.
Let's go to Isaiah. Let's see what yes, Yahweh have to say. You know, Isaiah was a powerful prophet.
Yes.
He had his head on straight. Got all his ducks was in the row.
Yes.
He dotted every I and crossed every T. He wasn't a man to play with. Isaiah chapter 5, verse number 7 says, "The vineyard of Almighty Yahweh."
Yes.
Do me a favor. Now, you don't have to, but it's just a speech that you need. I will never say vineyard. Never. Because I've learned that Yahshua said, I am the true vine. So what's in his yard? The vine yard. So this is vineyard to snatch away the beauty of the Messiah. To me, this is the way I feel about it. You don't have to feel that way, I'm just telling you. See, to me, when they say vineyard, they're taking it away from my Messiah. He is the vine yard. He is the true vine in the vine yard. We got to be connected to the vine. If we in his yard. You understand what I'm saying? Now, you can blame the devil yard if you want. I'm going to be in his yard. I want to be a part of the vine. All right, for the vineyard of Almighty Yah of hosts is the house of Israel. See that? We are the vineyard. In other words, we are the ones connected to the vine in the vineyard. And the men of Yehuda, his pleasant plant. And he looked for judgment, but behold oppression. He looked for righteousness, and behold a cry. So you can't find too much righteousness in America today. Watch this. You can't find righteousness hardly nowhere. Let me say it right. You can't find righteousness hardly anywhere. Right? So there should be a cry being made. Because we got a lot of wrong going on. A lot of wrong is going on. So we need to be crying out to him. Isn't that right? Letting him know how we feel about it. What have you told a father lately about abortion? Quiet. What have you told a father lately about our young women giving their bodies up at a certain age, at a young age? What have you told a father about our young men giving their bodies up at a young age? So we must love him. We ain't crying out about it. Hello, somebody. What have you told a father lately about 70 churches teaching people wrong, people in our family? Then you cry out that the father was stopping and stopping in the hurry. When was the last time you cried out for any of that? So guess what? We satisfied with it. Because if you weren't satisfied with it, you'll cry out against it.
Yes.
I'm telling y'all, my next vision is to find out how can I get a meeting with the Supreme Court? Because I'm going to ask them some questions. How are you going to find out that Christmas is not a scriptural holiday and still contend to let our children be put out of school for 2 weeks to celebrate something that's not even spiritual? Y'all hear what I'm saying? And the same thing for Easter can be proven. But we let that happen. We're not crying out against that. Hallelujah. There's a line that's sitting over there, going to school. And I'm talking about elementary school. That's why I'm using her. That's my granddaughter. You know, now, we teaching her that Santa Claus is a lie. Christmas tree shouldn't even be talked about and all this kind of stuff. But as soon as she goes to school, they give her that picture to draw with Santa Claus and that in the rain game and all that. No, that shouldn't be going on if it's not real. Why are you still letting that happen? And the reason why it is, and because the saints of the Most High then close their mouth and will not cry out. There's time for somebody to cry out.
Hallelujah.
And those of you that's listening, that are not here, but listening on television or radio, if you know how to get to them, please call me and tell me how to get to them. Because I want to do it. Somebody needs to step up. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm not satisfied with it at all. Acts chapter 7, verse number 60. And I usually get myself in trouble speaking out for everybody else or everybody else hiding under the table. You know what I'm saying? I lost a job like that before. A good job. Speaking out for everybody else. And when the time came, when the pressure came, everybody ran except me. But it didn't happen against my father's will. He wanted me to leave from there. Because the very person I was working next to 6 months later was dead. Wow. That's right. The father wanted me out of that stuff, working on the cameras.
Hallelujah.
Acts chapter 7, verse number 6, he said these words. And he kneeled down and cried with a loud, what kind of voice?
Loud voice.
Tribulation to them that trouble you. And to you who have trouble, and to you who are troubled, rest with us. When the master Yahushua shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels. Y'all heard that? Rest with us. Now, what is the word rest? See, right today? Today is a day of rest.
Yeah.
We need some people to come rest with us. That's the way we need to invite them. Come rest with us this Sabbath. What do you mean, rest with us? It's the day of rest. Come rest with us. We're going to rest in him. We're going to rest in praise. We're going to rest in worship. We're going to rest in prayer. We're going to rest in hearing the word from heaven. And then we're going to rest at the tables and eat together. Come on, rest with us. Take a day. Don't you think they will come? There will be our hope anyway, won't it?
Yes.
See, look. Anybody here got family members you need to come out with?
Yes.
Are you crying out?
Yes.
Crying out?
Yes. Not enough.
See, I'm looking at y'all, and I'm saying, are you crying out? But we got more than the four hands that I saw. You got something you need to cry out for.
Hallelujah.
And I can't tell you your business like you know your business. You know your business. But I guarantee you, everybody in here got something to cry out for.
Hallelujah.
Whether you raise your hands or not. See, but that's just a sign of our stubbornness. See, we just stubborn. We so stubborn, we don't even want to do the Father want us to do. We won't even acknowledge our own faults and failures. We won't do none of that. We won't confess that we're wrong. But you want something from him.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Help us, Father.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now. I cry out. And I don't care who hear me. The other day I grabbed my shofar and I started blowing my shofar. Making a noise in my house, in my camp. Hallelujah. But I want the Father's attention. Do you want his attention in your matters, in your situation? Because I'm going to tell you right now, whether you want to accept it or not, he's the only one that can fix it for you.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. You can try everything that you think is going to work, and I guarantee you all of your efforts are going to be in vain.
Thank you.
Yes,
but the minute you put him in the front and let him work it out,
he's
going to get done.
Yeah.
I want my children to be saved. I'm not ashamed to say that. I want all my children to be saved, to be on fire for the Father. I want them in this congregation with me because I know this is the truth. I want that. I need that. Got to have that. So I cry out, help!
Help
me, Father, to get them out of the world into your son. Help, Father!
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I cried out for my sister. She's here.
Hallelujah.
I cried out for my brother. He's here.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I cried out. And the Father heard my humble
cry.
Now, if you don't want to cry out for yours, Brother Isaac can't make you. But somebody in the neighborhood ought to hear you sometimes calling on him. Am I making sense to you? Now, you can whisper all you want, but that ain't what he said to do. He said, cry out. He said, he that has a broken and a contrite spirit, I want to know why it turned away. See, when you're broken, you don't care what nobody else think about you. Y'all think my fire is getting deep. I may am. My fire getting deep. I'll cry out in a minute. I'm a brother out of here. Hold on, let me put you in my fire. Lord, let me draw my hand. I don't care what you feel about me. That's me crying out.
Yeah.
If you don't want to cry out for your elder heat, I'm crying out for mine.
Yeah.
So we're going to look at Deuteronomy chapter 4. Deuteronomy, that Deuteronomy, chapter 4. We're almost finished. Hallelujah. The Father speaking to our hearts today.
Yes, indeed.
Hallelujah. He had to set up for us to hear this message.
Thank you.
Time for us to come now.
Yes.
Oh, that's what y'all know. Verse number 30. He said, when you are in tribulation, what are we expecting to come, Christian?
Tribulation. Great tribulation.
Yes. When you are in tribulation, and all these things are come upon you, even when?
The latter days.
Who is he talking about? He's talking to Israel. These are the latter days we're in.
Yes.
If you turn to Almighty God, your Elohim, and will be obedient unto his voice. Y'all see that? For Almighty Yah, your Elohim, is the merciful of him. He will not forsake you.
Hallelujah.
Neither will he destroy you.
Yeah.
Nor will he forget the covenant of your father, which he swore to them. In other words, he said, I will be right there with you if you call on me. If you can come to me when tribulation comes, I'll be there with you.
Yes.
We need it when I was having tribulation. Scripture said this is the worst time ever gonna hit the world.
Yeah.
So you know what? We're gonna be able to walk through.
Yes, indeed.
And sing that song. Yeah. I walk through the garden alone.
Yes, indeed.
While the dew is still on the rose. And the boys are here falling on my ear. The sun of Yah is cold. Yesterday, ice and fire falling out the sky, and the earthquakes and the volcanoes erupting, and water erupting, falling at one another, and we're going to be strolling through.
Hallelujah!
That's what Brother Isaac did.
Yeah.
Why? Because he's going to be with us.
Hallelujah.
He's going to be merciful unto us.
Thank you.
That's what his word just said, right?
Yes.
He will not forsake us.
No,
that's his word, right?
Yes.
So we don't have to go through all of that.
Yes.
He said, I'm going to open up.
Hallelujah.
And let his bride go in there and be protected.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Praise him.
Hallelujah.
He has protected us this far.
That's right. Yes.
I can trust him to protect me all.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to tell y'all right now, they got starvation everywhere.
Yes.
If it ain't for food, it's for the word of Yah.
Indeed.
There's a famine in the land for the word.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. See, I purposely get my TV on Christian stations and listen. And you know what? He was starving.
Yeah. Starving for the word.
Because they didn't get the word. They didn't feel good doctrines and how to succeed in your business doctrines and how to get along with you. Well, not even with you. It's just how to get along on your job. All this kind of stuff, how to make plenty of money, and sow seed into this, and you don't get that. You know, come on, man, it's time now for that. We got too many people that don't know when they get before the Father, and they gonna say, well, I gave money to this organization, and they fed 100. I gave money to this one, and they told the neck, and I gave money to this one, and then I did this, man. This one going to St. Joe to heal them, and this one going to, and the Father say, hold on, hold on. I don't know you, and I never knew you.
Right.
You didn't keep my Torah.
Right.
You practice lawlessness. You let a man tell you, you don't have to obey me no more.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed.
So I don't know you. You know. See, we got to understand. People think the Father is going to be that little cushion thing that's okay. Right. That's okay. I know you're a sinner, but that's okay.
Right.
It's okay. Mm-hmm. But if you believe in the Messiah, you're going to be saved. Well, the devil going to be saved.
That's right.
Because he believed.
Yeah.
And the scripture said he believed in trembling.
Yeah.
Yes, he does.
And I don't see too many people trembling at the name of the gospel.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
See, we have to understand the Father is getting this thing ready, y'all.
Yes, he is.
I want to be on his side.
Yeah, me too.
Ain't no sense in me going through all I went through on this planet and got to go through hell. I cried about that last year yesterday.
Yesterday.
Now, I don't have to be crying no more. He said crying to be a thing of the past.
Yep.
Dying to be a thing of the past. Yeah. I don't want none of that. So I want to go where he said he want me to go. He made a way.
Yeah.
The Messiah said, I'm going to prepare a way for you.
Yep, that's what he said.
No, but what I'm going to do, instead of preparing a way for you, I'm going to send the way to you.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
And then Peter came up and said, I'm going to follow the way. Every step he took, I'm going to take it.
Hallelujah.
You should walk in his step. That's what he said.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Hallelujah.
So if he is the light, and the Father said, he is the light, and then he told us, the disciples, we are the light. Light draws light.
Yeah.
Light runs away darkness.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Darkness cannot exist with light.
Yeah.
So you can't tell me you're a sinner saved by grace. Mm. If you're saved by grace, you ain't a sinner no more.
Yes, indeed.
You're either one or the other.
Yes, indeed.
Take your pick.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Judges, that's your team again, chapter 10. Judges chapter 10. Praise Yah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Judges 10:14 says, go and cry out to the mighty ones which you have chosen, and let them save you in your time of distress.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the children of Israel said to Yah, we have sinned. Do to us whatever is good in your eyes, but just deliver us, please. See, when we finally realize Santa Claus can't help us, the Easter Bunny can't help us, a broken Valentine can't help us, Mardi Gras can't help us, and none of that junk can't help us, then we're going to call on the Almighty, because that's the only help that we have. And he's a very present help in the time of trouble.
Hallelujah.
Well, we get to that point, but I don't know what it's going to take to get us to that point that we're going to cry out to him as if that's the only hope we got. Because we have not yet realized that we're the only hope we got. We got too many different alternatives.
Mm-hmm.
That's our problem.
Yes, indeed.
Brother, I'm asking for some bread, but if you don't give me that, I'm going to the bread store.
He's our inheritance.
I'm going to ask him to bless me with some money to pay my bills, but if he don't, I'm going to the loan company.
Yeah.
So we got alternatives.
Yeah.
But what's going to happen when all them alternatives are gone?
None.
But then he knocked them out one by one right now.
That's right.
Business is shutting their doors.
Yep.
What you going to do then?
Have faith
then. See, you got to have faith then.
Yeah.
But see, faith comes by hearing the word that's preached to you by a preacher.
Yeah.
Oh, my people didn't like that, but I got to say it again. Oh, wow. Faith comes by hearing the word that's preached to you by a preacher.
Yeah.
And that's what the word said.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
But then he said, he gave apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers for the edifying of the body of Mashiach.
Yeah.
Isn't that right? Yeah. Till we all come to the unity of the faith.
Hallelujah.
That's for the work of the ministry. So he got it all set up. You can try to mess up his setup all you want to, and all you're going to do is mess up yourself.
Right.
Yeah. You ain't going to mess him up.
No.
His is going to work out.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
So they ended up by saying, whatever you're going to do to us, do it, but deliver us.
Okay.
How many of y'all need deliverance?
Hallelujah!
Yeah. And look what they ended up by saying, please. They said that in King James Version?
Says we pray this day.
Now he said, please. Acts 14. Hallelujah.
We got
one more book to go to after this, and we're going to stop. I think. If the Father says so.
Hallelujah.
I'm a prisoner of the Most High.
Yes.
Do I have any fellow prisoners?
Yeah.
Well, if you're a fellow prisoner, you can't go unless he says this.
Yeah.
You can't go unless he says this.
Yes.
You can't be.
He got the keys.
Unless he says be.
Yes.
That's right. So he got the keys to the cell.
That's right.
Yeah.
So if you're a fellow prisoner, There's some things you just want to jump up and do, he ain't gonna let you.
Hallelujah.
So whatever you don't want me to do, I don't want to do it.
Yes, indeed.
But I'm scared to do it otherwise.
Hallelujah.
Acts 14, 22. Strengthening the beings or the souls of the disciples, the top ones. What should I be doing, Father? Encouraging them to continue in the faith.
Hallelujah.
And that through many
tribulations,
many pressures, many anxieties, much stress, we have to enter into the kingdom.
Hallelujah.
It's not going to be a cakewalk
into
the kingdom. You got to go through something. It's not an easy road.
Yes,
this is not an easy street. No. In this road, it's got obstacles. In this road, it's got things you got to jump over, and rivers you got to cross, and mountains you got to climb, and valleys you got to come out of. In this road, it's got life and death, it's got tears and sorrow, and it's got a little joy. In this road, it's not an easy road, y'all. But it's a road that we can make it through.
Yes.
Because at the end of the road, how many of y'all are taking your eyes off the road and see the destination?
Yeah.
See, when you take your eyes off the road, all you see is the kingdom over there.
Yes!
Yep.
I
didn't
care about the road,
as long as
you see the kingdom.
One time I was coming from Jackson, Mississippi, somewhere there, and I dropped my van there, and I wanted to get home so bad, I was so tired. You know, all I could see was my house.
Yes, indeed.
And I went right past the independent agent. So I said, man, I'm past the agent now. So I got down there to take off, turned back around, my mind on my house again.
Wow. Pass it up again.
Pass the agent up again. I said, Father, what's going on? My vision was on the house, not on the road. Right. So I came back this time, I said, I'm going to keep my eyes on the road. And I saw the independent sign saying 1 mile. Pass it again. But my mind was on the pots, my mind was on the painting, my mind was on getting to the house. But on the last trip, I said, you know what? I'm going to go slow. And I'm going to think about this. And I got off on the independent side. But that just taught me that if I put my mind on the kingdom, everything else got for me.
That's right.
I can pass by you and don't even see you, devil, because my mind is on the kingdom.
Hallelujah.
I can be hungry and pass by you, pig, because my mind is on the kingdom. Somebody ought to know what I'm talking about. I don't need all this. All I need to do is get to the kingdom. And he promised me.
Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Romans chapter 12. We're going to stop with Romans chapter 12. No, we're not going to verse number 1. Let's say, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God. We're not even going to Romans chapter 12, verse number 2. We did not perform Israel. We're not going there either. We're going to Romans chapter 12, verse 10. Information for us.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
God. Here is some good instruction in verse number 10.
Thank you, God.
Be kindly affectionate. One to another. Can we do that?
Yes.
With brotherly love.
Yes.
Can we do that?
Yes, by the Spirit.
In honor preferring one another.
Yes.
Now what that saying, buddy? What that saying is, rather than me, Brother Stanley, prefer to be with one of my old time buddies, I should prefer to be with you.
Hallelujah.
Preferring one another.
Yep, that's true.
Everybody, please hear what I just said.
Yes, indeed.
Because see, we still say we have friends that's in the world.
Yeah.
But let me give you a clue. I want you to look up the word friendship. Look up the word friend. Look it up in the encyclopedia. Look it up in a big time, powerful dictionary. Not that little jump shot like Webster. Go higher than Webster. And look up the word friend. You know, look it up scripturally. Look it up scripturally. The word friend. When they say Abraham was a friend of Yahweh. That's what he said, right?
Yeah.
Now, when you look at the word friend, what do I mean? Likeness or sameness.
Okay.
So what he was saying was, Abraham had the likenesses of Yahweh.
Hallelujah.
See, he was hospitable. He invited people to his
home.
See, Messiah was a friend. He said, there is no greater love than this that a man laid out his life for who? For somebody who is just like him.
Yep.
Come on, somebody out here.
Yeah.
See, people think he laid down his life for the whole world. No, he's not. He laid his life down for those who he befriended. Those who became his friends.
Yeah.
That's what he laid his life down. Now, what he did was lay his life down for the whole world, but the whole world don't want to be his friends.
Right.
Yep. They don't want to be like him. They want to be like who they are, like somebody else.
Yes, indeed.
Somebody want to be like Tupac.
Yeah, that's right.
They don't want to be like him.
They don't want to be like him.
They want to dress like Tupac, look like Tupac, sing like Tupac, get the money like Tupac.
Yeah.
And the father said, no, 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 no. Be like my son.
Come on.
Be like my son. Because I'm not going to recognize you unless you look like him.
Hallelujah.
See, if you don't look like him, I don't know you.
Right.
Father, help us today.
Yeah.
Can we prefer one another?
Yes, indeed. Hallelujah.
We like going on cruises. I like cruises, but I sure prefer y'all go with us.
Yeah.
When I go there, I go somewhere with God and lost man. I love going there with my brother.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, that's true. Y'all might not want to go to me because, you know, I might be kind of dull to y'all. I'm going to tell y'all like that. Y'all better catch up.
Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, next verse he says, do not be slothful in your business.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Lazy.
Don't be lazy.
Mm-hmm.
Be lazy.
But I need you to be fervent in your spirit.
Hallelujah.
Serve the Almighty God. Do I see fervency in here?
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes. Not gonna be honest, I'm the pastor, so I'm gonna tell you. Sometimes I see a fervent spirit in here, but a whole lot of times I see some dead folks.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I'm speaking to today. We need to come out of that deadness and come alive. And cry out!
Yes!
Wake up!
Thank you!
When we cry out, verse 12 says, we ought to be rejoicing in the hope that we have.
Yes!
We ought to be patient in our tribulations.
Hallelujah!
And continuing instant in prayer.
Yes!
Yep.
That's what we need.
Cry out.
Yep.
Hallelujah!
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 Anybody ready to cry out?
Hallelujah!
This morning, we had a crying out prayer.
Yeah.
We cried out in prayer.
Thank you, Father.
All that little shim sham was gone. All that shame faces was gone. All that little quiet, immune spirit was gone. And somebody had some fire in their heart and we cried out.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And because we cried out this morning, I expect to get some
food.
Signifying that she's not going to say this.
Give it all.
You don't give it all. That's the way I felt this morning. So when I came here to give it all.
Hallelujah.
And if it would have been what it was last night, we had a mighty number of three last night.
Hallelujah.
So you know what? He was here last night.
Hallelujah.
But he's here two or three.
Yeah, right.
Out in the midst of all that cold and ice and snow, three people showed up.
Wow.
It don't matter who the three are.
That's right.
But the three people showed up.
Thank you.
Oh,
yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I came here today to give him all of me.
Hallelujah.
I don't want to bring nothing home but the Bible. Just about to get the little break. Hallelujah. But I just give him my praise.
Hallelujah.
All my heavenly
gifts.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Get all my heavenly
gifts.
That woman poured all
thank you.
On him.
Yes.
she did that, you think she had an IBC file?
No.
I bet she did. Don't you know we could have sold out all the dead and money to feed the poor?
Yeah.
No. She said, no, leave that one alone. She's done a good work.
Hallelujah.
She paid my body.
Hallelujah.
All the day.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to tell you what you do, since you had something to say. Whenever you preach this message of good news, tell somebody
about that
one.
Hallelujah.
So they can be glory of us. Well, Father, I've done what you've already done.
Hallelujah.
And I pray right now that you receive it.
Hallelujah.
In heaven.
Hallelujah.
But I'm going to call for those